Well, happy 50th, Junos. This is really an important night for our music industry, and we're truly honored to be a part of this celebration.
Amazing that 50 years ago, Walt Grielas and Stan Cleese, the publishers of RPM magazine, created the Juno Awards and named the award after CRTC chair Pierre Juno. Juno was the architect of those great Canadian content regulations, giving more airplay to Canadian artists. Coincidentally, the CanCon rules are also celebrating their 50th.
Also tonight, our dear friend Jan Arden officially enters the Canadian Music Hall of Fame presented by TD. And this is a really special moment in an artist's career. I remember how nervous and excited we were at our induction. You think it's emotional to get inducted into the Hall of Fame by your hero, Geddy Lee? Imagine standing this close to Jim Cuddy.
When Blue Rodeo was inducted in 2012, well before Ed's band, Sarah McLachlan performed with us. It was such a special night, and it was an incredible thing to become a Hall of Famer.
Jan will be performing from Studio Bell, home of the National Music Center in Calgary, where the Canadian Music Hall of Fame resides. And now, to make the official presentation, a true legend, unlike these pretend legends, she is a member of the Hall of Fame.
And a major part of Canadian music history. Here to induct Jan Arden into the Canadian Music Hall of Fame, presented by TD, the one, the only,
Anne Murray.
My first memory of Jan Arden was listening to her sing Insensitive on the radio. I loved the song and I loved the voice. My second memory of Jan was a brief meeting at the Junos. I invited Jan to come to my golf club to play golf with me once. She showed up at the golf club in jeans, a lumberjack shirt, and boots. And of course, they would not let her play golf looking like that. So I had to buy her a whole new outfit. And added to that, she frequently tells lies about me on stage. Now, having said all of that, you're probably wondering what I'm doing here. But as most of us know, Jan has a wicked and wonderful sense of humor. She's one of the funniest people I've ever known. And not only is she funny and a fine singer-songwriter, she's also a fine human being. Anytime I've called upon her, she's been there for me. She is warm, witty, kind, compassionate, and wears her heart on her sleeve. I'm proud to call her a friend, and I'm honored to invite her into the Canadian Music Hall of Fame.
I'm sitting here today because of music. I think I would have died 100 times over. I think I survived my dad's alcoholism because of music, because of being a creative person.
Wrap yourself inside all the goodness that you've had.
Dear Jan, has it really been over 25 years since our love affair with you began? The first time we heard your angelic voice, we knew you were something special. You opened your heart, and we fell in.
I never thought an overweight kid from Springbank, Alberta, could aspire to go into music. People are always like, what's your big break? I'm like, I never had one. It's thousands of seemingly insignificant events.
Maybe.
And then we discover the other side of your talents.
Hello, Canada! Okay, gently, put me down!
Brave. Funny.
Do you have any tats?
I've got one in Canada on my bum, and every time I fart, Quebec separates.
And television star.
I think that's Jan Arden.
Damn it.
My mom's gonna be so excited that I met you.
With your words and your music, you gave voice to not only your own joy and heartbreak, but ours as well.
I leave the light on.
Yes, she is a singer and songwriter, first and foremost, but she is also a writer of fiction, a writer of nonfiction, she's a visual artist, and she's an actor. And she does all of these things wonderfully. And at the same time, she's nice to people, which is why they call her Saint Jan of Alberta.
It's amazing being yourself.
What a concept. I could be exactly who I was. I could be a little bit nutty, and I could be fiercely loyal to the serious nature of my work.
Congratulations to a good friend and an even greater artist.
Nobody deserves this award more than you.
You have an endless capacity for kindness, and you're such a beautiful woman. Every single room you've ever walked in your life has been lit up. On behalf of all Canadians, and I think I can speak for them when I say this, we're all better for having known you. I love you, Jan. What else can I say? I just love you.
We love you. Sincerely, Canada.
Hello, everybody. I am so, so very grateful to be here tonight with all of you, sitting in your living room, sitting in your pajamas, sitting wherever you're sitting, wherever you are. I'm so happy to be with you tonight. I am so humbled for this unbelievable honor. I really still can't believe I'm standing here holding this. It's very surreal. And I think I'm too young, don't you? I'm far too young. So grateful to everyone who has helped me over the years. And oddly enough, I am also very grateful for the ones who did not, because they only serve to make me stronger, way more persistent, more resilient, more empathetic. And if I've learned anything in my life up to this point, it is that good things come out of bad things. Music has shaped my entire life in a way that is really difficult to articulate completely. My dad, who I love despite his many difficulties in his own life, was a really terrible alcoholic the entire time that I was growing up. And for that reason, I did whatever I could to stay out of his way. That was my main goal, to stay clear of him. And that meant going into our basement. And our basement was where the old record player was. There were stacks of vinyl. Listening to music became everything to me. My therapist, my comfort, my security, my teacher, my friend, my solace, my joy, my confidence, you get it. It just was my whole world sitting down there playing records. When my mother was near the end of her life, in the grips of Alzheimer's, and she didn't know who she was or where she was or why she was, when we played a song for my mom, she could sing along. She could tap her foot. And it was those moments when I knew, and we all knew, that she was still in there. Music is magic. Music is unbelievably special and important to human life. It always has been, and it always will be. Thank you to all of you for inviting me into your lives, into your minivans, into your basements. It has been such an incredible life so far. I'm gonna keep going right up until I can't and I don't. So thank you, Canada. Thank you to all my fans all over the world. Good night, look after yourselves.
I'm so honored to be here at this incredible event. It's hard to believe it's been 2 years in the making. The entire country cherishes her, and she's written lyrics for us that have defined the most important moments in our lives. Ladies and gentlemen, the most recent inductee into the Canadian Music Hall of Fame presented by TD, my fellow Albertan, Jan Arden.
could say I'm hard to hold, but if you knew me, you'd know I've got good father, and his strength is what makes me cry. Feet on ground, heart in hand, facing forward, be yourself.
Facing